Router is a network layer device, a network layer device, and it work on the layer 3. Okay, layer 3 basically, in the layer 3, that is we configure the IP address based on the IP address. IP address is a logically assignation. And if you talk about the switch that work on the MAC layer, okay, we will discuss about this. And earlier I was giving the example of F5 device. F5 is a load balancer. Okay, suppose this is our F5 device. Okay, F5, you know the F5 load balancer. What is load balancer? Load balancer.
The thing is that if there is some heavy data from two sites, it balances and sends the output in the same. It balances the bandwidth.
Okay, so let me make the diagram. Okay, this is your client. Okay, like we have a HTTP or HTTPS server. Okay, means HTTP work on port 80 and HTTP work on 443. Actually, I have to explain this after you the OSI. I think that on that time you will get the better understanding about the layers. Okay, so but no issue. Let me complete this and after that I will also explain about that. Like we have a application and application number is HTTP is 80 port number and HTTPS is a 443. Okay, so suppose we have a single server. Okay, on that time, like what will be happen, like if client sending the request, that request will become on the single server. Okay, that can be the issue if the device goes fail down and any disaster issue. Okay, so on that time F5 provide us the load balancing. Like in the F5 behind of this we can add the multiple server and we can use the same application. Like what it will provide, like it will provide the advantage if client is sending the request on F5 device. Okay, it will be send the request on every available node one by one based on the algorithm. Okay, what he has decided, like by default that is take the round robin. Round robin means every request will become on the every device one by one. Okay, like first request here, second request here, third request here, fourth here, fifth here, 6, 7, 8, 9. So this type every request will be come. Okay, so the concept is if we can monitor two way monitor means how F5 know my application and my this server is okay. Okay, so every 5 to 5 second it send the hello packet to check the server are alive or not. Okay, like it will check the port setting and application setting. Okay, so you can see like your F5 work on the layer 4 and layer 7. Layer 7 is like on the application layer. We can see like HTTP and HTTPS. So these are the application like which work on the application layer. Application layer means like when user directly authentication with user. Okay, because user will work on the application layer is a you can say the user entity. Okay, in the application like user will open the system and that will work on the application. So in the application like that is directly attached with the user. Okay, because on the machines like user will do some application, some contents, and after that he will send the data to one to another system. Okay, so here like it work on the 4 and 7. 4 means it will be the monitor the port setting. Port means where it is connected, okay, and like TCP by default, TCP either UDP. I will explain you today about the transport layer. So here you will learn about the layer 4, how it work, and about the F5 layer 7. Like in the behind of this, we have a multiple applications. So our main task is to access the applications here only, because in the data center, in every network, like how the manage in the production, like user need to access their applications. So as per the network engineer, you have to maintain your network. Means user can easily access the applications. Even you have a load balancer, even you are using the firewall, you have a good network, you have to good understanding about the your structure. Like you need to maintain that. You will be work in the operation team. Okay, in the operation, like every services should be okay. Okay, so it's clear now. During the time of troubleshooting, and every device work on the layers. Okay, so I will also explain you about the device level, like which device work on which layer. It's clear.
Okay.
Venkit. Yeah. Okay. So I will also provide you the diagram and about the OSI. Okay. Basically, every time like you will face the which device work on which layer and how your data is traveling. So based on the OSI model, you can easily troubleshoot that, and you can easily identify like my encryption is working or not. Like suppose I am telling you, I have sent the data from, suppose I have system. Okay. Actually right now might be you are getting, okay, because OSI is still not completed. Okay, suppose we have a two system. Okay, we are sending the data from here to here, but on the system two, like there is a authentication. Authentication means I have set some encryption value like 123 password. Okay, suppose this is not aware about that, this PC is sending data to here. So I can easily understand like encryption work on which layer. That is a presentation, means your presentation is not working here on that time. That can be issue like your authentication, your encryption, and your compression. Okay, like so this kind of thing, this can be issue. Okay, you can understand like suppose you have a two device. Here you have set the IP address, here you have set the IP address. Okay, when you connect the board device, you are not able to see the IP address, only MAC is coming. Okay, it means your network is working on only layer 2, okay, not a layer 3, because IP are not exchanging. So you can easily analyze like first layer was presentation, second is data link layer. Your traffic is going on data till the data link layer, not going on the network layer. So on that time you can analyze your IP address only. You will not look on the entire network. Okay, so during the time of troubleshooting, it will help. Now, okay.
Yeah.
Okay. So during the time of troubleshooting, I will also explain you in the ongoing session how what kind of issue you can face in the live scenario. And most of the time, like we will discuss about the real time issues, okay, which we face in the my organizations. Okay. session layer we have complete, no? So do you have any question till here?
Yes.
Application, no. Word working, presentation, session layers. Okay, and one more thing, like you also receive the videos or class video?
I don't think.
Okay. Okay. So next layer is what is this low layer? Okay. So here, like we have explained about the till session layer and about the duplex and half duplex, and now like we will discuss about low layer. Low layer, like these are the hardware entity. Okay. So in the low layer, you will see the transport layer. Second is okay. Physical layer, second is data link layer, third is network layer, and four is transport layer. In the transport layer, like transport layer, that is the layer four, does not actually send data, okay, and despite its name, and instead this layer is responsible for reliable transfer of data by ensuring that data arrives at its destination error free in order. Okay, so what it will be do? No. You have two system. Let me open the one diagram. Can see here. Okay, so we are discussing about the transport layer. Okay, basically transport layer, what is provide? Like it provide the end-to-end reliability. Okay, like it provide the reliability, like data is from source to destination, data is sent or not. Okay, it provide the it provide the end-to-end you can see here. Okay, end-to-end connectivity, like it provide, and end-to-end reliability. Okay, so in the transport layer, you will see there are two protocols, okay, which work on transport layer. So these are the protocol, okay, TCP and UDP. So these are the protocol like which work on the transport layer. Okay, if you talk about the TCP, TCP is a connection oriented, and UDP is a connectionless. Okay, what is a connection oriented? Like it require that a connection with specific agreed upon permanent to establish before data is sending. Okay, so like what is the TCP? So there are two type here, like TCP IP, and one is TCP and another is a UDP. If you talk about the TCP, when you send the data to your remote device, okay, like it provide you the acknowledge as well. If you are using the TCP, TCP is a protocol. Okay, you can manually select here TCP either UDP. So here are some different between the TCP and UDP. The best way is a TCP. TCP, like, it provide the acknowledgement. It's a connection oriented and connectionless. Okay. Like, when you send the data from PC1 to PC2, okay, so it will send the data from PC1 to PC2 and also provide you the acknowledgement. Okay, like your data has been delivered. Okay, but if you talk about the UDP, and if you are using the UDP on that time, like, it only send the data to another one. It doesn't provide any acknowledgement, like your data has been traveled or received by end user or not. Okay, so there are some different between here, and there are a lot of difference, like why it happened. Like, when you send the data from here to here, this is a one time you send the data, okay, and next time, like, it will be send you reverse data also. So there are two lookup, one is sending, another is receiving. So and it will also provide you the acknowledgement. So on that time, like, it is a little bit slow, but if you talk about the UDP, it is a fast. Okay, your videos, your voice work on UDP. Like, now we are, I share my screen and we are communicating with each other. Okay, so on that time, like, what whatever I have talked, okay, what I have explained, suppose you didn't listen, so on that time, that will be not repeat, that will be not repeat again in the middle of our further communications. Okay, but if you talk about here, like, TCP provide you acknowledgement, like, suppose if data is not received from the end user, like, it will be provide until the message will be delivered. Okay, so there are some different between the TCP and UDP. You understand that?
Yeah, got it.
Okay, you can also, yes, go sir, through from here, like connection oriented and connectionless. Require no connection before data is sending. Okay, and connection oriented, segment and sequencing, and connection establishment or not, acknowledgement and flow control and error control, it will also check. This is about the UDP and this is about the TCP. Okay, so most of the time, like, every time we use the TCP, but for the okay, so there is, like, for the fast conversion we use the UDP. If we don't require to for the acknowledgement and any reliable connection, so on that time we use the UDP, rather than if we want to security purpose, on that time we use the TCP. Okay, and TCP is a three-way connection. Okay, if you talk about the TCP, let me tell you how TCP work. TCP, you can also go on Google, TCP three-way handshake. Okay, sometime interview can ask, what is TCP and what is the TCP three-way handshake? Okay, so on that time, like, you had to good understanding about this. Three-way handshake, it's easy, but you have to know about that. TCP handshake, okay, so this is your host and this is your destination. Okay, when host A will be sent to host B. Okay, suppose you are sending data from here to here, either you are just doing the ping, you know, the ping, ping, window plus r, cmd, EING.
Yeah.
Okay. When host is sending the ping request either and data sending, so before that it will send the TCP three-way handshake. Okay, so on that time what will be happen, like it will be send the SYNAC packet, synchronization packet, and it will receive the sync and it will send the request like yes, I can receive your data, okay, I am alive, and next time your session will be established. Okay, first of all, like it will check the reachability and device is alive or not, that is capable to receive the data or not. So if everything is okay, so on that time like your request will be forward. So these are the behind process we can't see. We okay, here we generally we see we want to send data from here to here, we directly send data. Okay, but this is a behind process of every sending data, and for the troubleshooting part in the network, for the network node only, okay, we use the OSI. Okay, and this is only about the TCP. Okay, it's clear now.
Yes,
let me copy this. Okay, today you will receive this document, so you can go through here.
Okay. And you also told that you will be sending the link for the CCNA site.
CCNA site?
No, the documents are what do we call it?
Okay, network device.
The topics, yeah, network device topics.
Okay, okay. I forgot, I think. Okay, no issue. You will receive today. Definitely, you will receive. Okay. And
okay, sir.
Those are the network device part. Like, you can also make note, and you can also search on Google as well. On the Cisco site, you will get the more information. Okay. If you want,
okay.
So I will also send you for the better understanding. Let me download.
Oh, you're just sending the PDF directly. The PDF code.
PDF, I think I'm not able to send you directly, but I will try.
No. Save as PDF.
I will send you only link. This link.
Okay, sir.
Okay, and you can try here. I will send you the link. Okay, so here
Even if you send in the even if you send in the chats chat box also, I think we can try to open it, right?
Where is chat box here?
Hello. Oh, you okay.
Not a chat box.
Okay, I think we don't have the access to for chat box. Okay.
So. Yeah, I will discuss so we can get. Okay, so next one, close it now till the time. Can you see screen?
No, sir.
Okay. So, next one is OSI network layer. Okay. This one now it's visible, I think.
Yes, sir. Now we can
Like on the network layer, network is the over layer 3, and roles inter-network communications, and the two key responsibility. Okay, one is the logical addressing, it means the IP address, and second is for routing. Okay, so there are the two key features. It provides the routing facility end to end, like determine the best path to a particular destination network and then route data accordingly. Okay, routing means like if you want to send the data from one subnet to another or one source to destination. So if you have a different subnet, so on that time your router will be provide the communications. And next one is a logical addressing. Logical addressing like your IP address, okay, provides a unique addressing that identify both the host and the network that host exists on. Okay, so these are the function of network layer. Okay, this is a very simple layman language. And next one is a two of the most common protocol. One is IP and second is IPX. Okay, so now IPX is a not using, so generally you most of the time people use the IP address. IP address, you know, that is a logical IP addressing. Okay, so these are the IP addressing scheme. Okay, inter-network packet exchanging process of the novel system. But nowadays we are using the IP protocol. Most of the time we follow the Cisco standard. And okay, your every L3 device, like on device we can assign the IP address. Okay, so that work on the layer 3. Okay, you have to understand that. And next, your next layer is a data link layer. Okay, if you talk about the data link layer, like it is responsible for transporting data within a network. Okay, like here it will also provide you the error control and data control. Okay, network layer is consist with transporting data between the network, and like is responsible for transporting data within a network. So this is the responsibility of network data, sorry, data link layer. And there are two sub layer. Okay, first is the LLC, and another is a MAC. MAC is a media access control. Like MAC is your physical IP, physical address. And if you talk about the LLC, logical link layer control, it provide the like connectivity of the upper layer, like in the data. In the data link layer, like IP address will not work, it will be send the data based on the MAC address only. Okay, okay, if you talk about the switch scenario, like it store the MAC address table. So this is your MAC address table. Okay, okay, so this, it will create this type of table. on the switch we have a 3 PC connected, first 2 and 3. Okay, and if you talk about the switch MAC table, you can't see the IP address here, and because switch work, it's know about the only MAC address, that's it. It will not understand the IP address. Okay, so on the first you can see the VLAN. By default you will see the VLAN 1 only. Okay, I will also explain about the VLAN concept. And if it, and in the next line you will see the MAC address. These are the MAC address of every device. On the PC 1 we have a for this we have a this MAC address for this one and this one. On the switch end you can see the this table, and the type is dynamic, and port are PC1 is connected on this port, PC2 connected on this port, PC3 connected on this port. So this information, it's switch store the this information on their MAC table. That is called the MAC table, MAC MAC table. Okay. On the switch end, like you can see, during the time of practical labs, I will also show you about the MAC. Okay, we will also discuss about, but here you have two basic understanding. Like if talk about the MAC address and a device, so on that time you have to aware during the time of troubleshooting, you have to understand about the OSI. So that's the way we are doing the study of OSI, and these are the basic of networking. Devices, OSI model, cabling, and IP address, okay, and topology. So these are the just basic understanding of networking. So if you are not understanding that, so that will be during the time of creating lab designing, you will face the lot of issue. If you are not aware about the how to sign the IP address, how to create your labs, how to design your network, okay, so that will be very difficult. Okay, here like you can see, these are the document. Okay. Like if you want to see the application level, which application work on the here, these are the applications. Okay, these are the some application which work on here. And if you talk about the presentation layer, your compression, encryption, you can see from here. And in the session layer, your handshaking. On the TCP layer, you will see the your TCP and UDP packet segmentation. Okay, and on the network layer, like your IP, IP version 6, your ICMP. Okay, ICMP is a protocol that is a internet connection message protocol. Okay, so that used behind the ping request. Okay, when you send the ping request, so that will be provide you the reachability of destination. Okay, and another means the IPsec, MPLS, ARP. So these are the some protocol which work on the network layer. And on the data link layer, your MPLS MAC address, you can see the MAC address here, it work on the data link layer. On the physical end, you will see the cable connectors, etc. Okay. So, yeah, I want to show you this one. On the data link layer, like we have a two, in the data link, there are two types. One is a MAC and another is a LLC. Okay, LLC provide the communication between the network layer and data link layer. Okay, because in the network layer you are using the IP address, but here on the data link layer it use only on the frames. It use the frames and it doesn't work it on the MAC ad, sorry IP address. It based on the MAC only. Okay, so the responsible of LLC is logically link control. It provides a logically link between the network and data link layer to send the data on the physical and then destination. Okay, and if you talk about the MAC address, okay, MAC is a, most of the time we use the MAC address, that is a 48 bit. Let me show you MAC address. Okay, so this is your like your MAC address, and MAC address is a 48 bit IP address. Okay, so it divided in two part, like 24 and 24. Okay, first 24 is for vendor, like who is the vendor of this, and next 24 is decide your MAC address. Okay, device MAC address, device number. Okay, you can see here okay, device and your serial number. And is there any document for that? Let me check. Okay, so if you see about your LAN card, okay, where is that? Yeah, you can see this is your netgear. It can be wireless air card. Okay, so on the wireless card, like you can see the MAC address. So this is your MAC address. On the physical device, like you can see this is your permanent address. Okay, and to see the MAC address, like we have a command cmd, you can get the MAC address via this command get MAC. you can see the multiple MAC address here, but for your device interface, actually it's showing me the 6 or 7, because if you see about the ncpa.cpl, I have multiple network connections, like 6 or 7 connection I have. So based on that, like it's showing me the MAC address. But if you want to see the specific which I am using, like right now I am using the wireless here, so my MAC address will be ipconfig and /all. What is this? Okay, so this is my wireless connection, and okay, let me tell you ipconfig all. Okay, so this is my wireless connection, and this is all detail about my device. okay, my device wireless, and this is my MAC address, okay, physical address, and I'm using DHCP. So these are the setting, like, and this is my logical IP address, that is the IP address, okay, and this is the link local. I will also explain you about this one, about the IP version 6, where during the time of IP version 6, this is a link local IP address, and this is my subnet mask. Okay, this is the default gateway and DHCP. I will also explain you, and these are the DNS. Okay, NetWare system. These are just like a DNS type, resolution type. So you can also go on your system, and you can type IP config all command. You can see this all setting. Okay, it's clear now. About the physical address, like, it physically assigned to your wireless card and any other devices. You can see MAC address on wireless card. Okay, this is your wireless card. You can see on this one also. Okay, first on the 24-bit, it will show you the vendor detail, and next one it will provide you the device, like this wireless device number. Through that you can easily identify this one, and you can also go on Google to check the MAC address, like which this MAC address belong to which device. That will also show you about the vendor detail and the device detail, like this is a wireless, this is a Cisco device, this is a switch, router, FI load balancer, whatever. Okay, that will also provide you. So it's clear now, or I had, do you want to explain me more? Hello.
Hello.
Yeah, I'm saying it's clear now, or you want to explain me more?
Yes, it's clear.
It's clear now?
No.
Okay.
Yes.
Okay. So in the document, like, there are a lot of document about the MAC address. Okay, so every time you will see the your MAC address on this format. Okay, this format, either you have another option, like sometime you can, you will see on this one also. Okay, like 0016 4134. Okay, these are double dotted, and 2CA6. Okay, so this format you will also see your MAC address. Okay, and our next layer is a physical layer. Physical layer is a layer one, controlling the signaling and transferring of row bits onto the physical medium. Okay, basically what is the role of physical layer? Like, it will provide the connectivity, end-to-end connectivity. Okay, and end-to-end connectivity, like these both PC are connected. Okay, how they are connected? They are using the cable, first of the cable. Second is they are using the RF, radio frequency. Third, they are using the wireless, okay, or any other medium. Like, it decide the media, how the device are connected with between each other. Okay, like cabling, connectors and transceiver. Okay, they are connected by NIC. NIC stands for network interface card. wireless radio or hubs. Okay, so any device can be like that provide the connectivity between the both end. The physical layer is closely related to the data link layer. Okay, as many technologies such as Ethernet contain both data link and a physical layer. Okay, so basically this is the work of physical layer, and sometime your hub, repeater, okay, so these devices work on the physical layer. Means when you connect the two devices to each other, so you can be use repeater and hub as well. Okay, switch also. Okay, and sometime you get the question from the interviewer. Okay, if I ask you, switch work on which layer? For both switch.
Listen.
Switch work on which layer?
Data link layer.
Data link layer.
Yeah.
Blanket. Okay. And what about Ramakrishna?
I guess it's on the physical layer. Well, it's like it's just transmitting, right?
Okay. How on data link layer and the physical layer?
Because switch mostly works on like MAC address, right? The data is transferred. Okay. So I think that is how it works. I guess.
And, how like you can say it work on the physical layer? Just one second. Just one thing. Okay, I'm back. So like earlier I tell you about the switch. Before 1.5 minutes I told you like about the physical layer also. Like switch work on the physical layer as well. Okay, and data link also. On the data link layer, like switch work on the MAC address. If we have a layer 2 switch, that work on the MAC address only. And if we have a like L3 device, L3 switch, that work on the layer 3. Okay, because on the multi-layer switch, that is a multi-layer switch. On the multi-layer switch, like we can also enable the IP address that provide the functionality of routing as well. Routing means if we want to communication between the two segments, and switch facility as well. That will provide the like we can connect the multiple ports. Okay, and it will also provide the L3 routing as well. So those are the multi-layer switch. And if you face the questions, so like you can easily tell switch work on the layer 1 and layer 2. For the layer 1, like I'm using hub here, na hub. I told you like
physical
okay,
layer.
Yeah, I told you about the hub. What is the use of hub? Like it provide the functionality where we can connect the multiple pieces. So same thing like switch also provide the this functionality. We can connect the multiple things like multiple devices. Like why we use switch here? Okay, suppose we want to connect from this device to this device, those are connected via this switch. Okay, either this device, okay, lot of device, and the distance is very long, so in the time you can use the switch okay, you can connect all device together. Okay, so it work on this way as well. What about next? So I think this is about the OSI model and just physical layer. Okay, let me check, is there any other thing in the picture? OSI TCP model and TCP suit. Okay, so let me connect my charger. Just wait till the time like you go through about this one, OSI model and DoD model. In the OSI there are the 7 layer and the DoD model are 4 layer. Read this 4 layer and check, like these are 3 and this is only single layer. Okay, these are the one layer, these are the 2 layer, these are the only 1 layer. Okay, just read it. I'm coming, 1 second.
Okay sir.
Okay, so I think you have go through that and so there is like another model. OSI model, TCP/IP model. Okay, so like these are the 2 model. Like if you talk about the difference between the 2 models, like close it. Okay, so here you can see in the OSI model we have 7 layer and the TCP/IP most of the time if we are sending the data on the in the internet and we use the TCP/IP and for network host to host, host connectivity, we use the OSI model reference. Okay, so like here you can see here independent standard acting as a communication gateway between the network and end user. Hello. Yes, ma'am. Is there any issue? For the same candidate. Oh. So you will join that one. Okay, so give me 10 minutes only. Okay, you can leave the session. Actually, I will tell to candidates, so they will again tell me like you are not completing the syllabus. Okay. So can you tell talk to candidate? No, on the middle of class, like can you tell? Yeah. Okay, so in the like OSI model, it provides the communication gateway between the network and user. Okay, so there is a difference between here, network and user, and TCP. If you talk about the TCP, it provides the TCP model is based on the standard protocol which the internet has deployed, and the TCP model and transport layer does not guarantee delivery of packet. Like if you are using like you are sending your traffic on the internet, and like you are accessing the remote location, so on that time you use the TCP model. But for the local hosting, local means you can say the LAN, okay, your LAN part. So network and end user, okay, so on that time OSI work. It's clear?
Yeah, yes sir.
Like this is the another different between the OSI and TCP. You can type on the Google and it will provide that TCP is a communication protocol that allow for connection of host to the internet. Okay, I think now it's clear. If you are sending the, you are making the connections between the towards to the internet, so on that time your TCP will work. Okay, like sometime you see ncpa.cpl, like here you can see this is my wireless. I right click on here. Properties. Okay, here you can see TCP, your TCP IP. Click here, TCP IP version 4 properties. So here I'm using the IP address. Okay, and like most of the time you use the TCP IP model if you are making the connection on the internet. On the your other hand, like your OSI is a communication gateway between the network and end user only. Okay, so these are the different. And if you talk about the like layers, so here you will see the 4 layer and here you will see the 7 layers. Okay, your application layer, transport, network and network interface. So these are the 4 layer. Okay, the work is same. You can see the comparison here. Your Ethernet connectivity, your ARP connectivity, your L3 connectivity. So like here they have combined the both, your MAC and physical. Your network is different, like transport is separate, but your application session and presentation layer, they have combined on the single layer. Okay, it's clear?
Yes sir.